Hey everybody, it's Sound Guy Barry with just a really quick tip for you. Now, if you're in a band or you're a sound guy, you know that equipment can take a beating. And in my experience, the number one thing that fails for me are these guys. Your cables, your mic cables. Maybe your guitar cables. And it figures because cables take a beating on stage. People are walking on them, tripping over them, yanking them. They get coiled and decoiled in shows. And all that twisting and flexing and pulling can cause one of the wires inside the cable to fail. Sometimes something heavy gets run over the cable and it breaks the cable in the middle. But more often, I find that there are bad connections between the wires and the connector, right up inside the connector. And that's a pretty simple fix. Now, if you have a suspect cable, you can ring it out with a voltmeter. You can tell if the cable is suspect in many cases because since this is a 3-pin cable, there's a ground line and two signal lines. If one of those signal lines gets broken, the cable will still appear to work, but the volume level out of that microphone will be diminished by about 6 dB. And so if one of the mics on stage doesn't seem to be quite as sensitive as the other mics, that's a sign to me that it might have a bad cable. And of course, if there's a broken signal line, the cable is more susceptible to picking up hum and buzz and noise. So that's not good. And you can check it out with your voltmeter by just making sure you got continuity between pin 1 on this connector and pin 1 on the other connector and 2 and 3, and that there's no shorts between any of those. But for an even easier, quicker check, I use a box like this, which is a EWI bug catcher. It's about $50, maybe $60. It's really been a great device. This is a very rugged box, works well. And you just plug the cable that's suspect into both sides of the box, like so. And you see there's a 5-position switch up here that will check out all of the wires in the cable, up to 5 wires, of course. And so you put it on position 1, and you should see LEDs on both sides lighting up, saying that 1-to-1 is connected. And you can go to 2, and you see that line 2-to-2 connects, and 3, and so forth. So you can really quickly see if there's any opens or shorts in your cables with a cable checker box like that. Of course, there's other companies who make cable checker boxes that are pretty similar. And I provided an earlier video of a homemade cable checker, which is just a 3-pin Canon XLR connector with a couple of LEDs inside of it, drop resistors. So you can apply phantom power to the cable from your mic preamp, and the LEDs will light up if they detect phantom power in both signal lines. And that's a pretty quick check as well. Not quite as complete of a check as a box like this, because it can't check every single possible failure condition. But that works well also. So I just wanted to pass that on. I think it's a really handy tool to have in your bag of tools. And it's not terribly expensive. And it lets you make sure that all your cabling is in good shape. Because having a bad cable during your show is going to give you less of a perfect show as it would be if you had working equipment. So, I hope that was a useful tip to you. And suggest you grab one of these guys if you don't have one already and you do a lot of shows. And I hope to see you again on another episode of Sound Advice.